Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Woodbridge, the best town around. And today we're the greenest town around. And welcome to the best day, I think, of the year in Woodbridge Township, which is the annual St. Patrick's Day Parade, sponsored by, not the township, but the American Irish Association of Woodbridge Township. People all day will tell me today, great job, great parade, you guys are wonderful. Well, we do a few things for the parade, that's fine. It's the American Irish Association and the officers here and the men and women and the parade chairs that really run this parade. It's a great thing for Woodbridge Township to have this parade. We're very, very proud of it. So thank you to start with the American Irish Association. I'd now like to ask our official bagpiper of Woodbridge Township, Mr. Paul DeLeo, to escort our honorees and our officers into the chamber. Thank you, Paul. While you're standing, please join me in the pledge to the flag.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And also, while you're standing, I'd like to call up Deacon William Lang from St. James Roman Catholic Church for the invocation.
St. Patrick was known for his devotion to the Trinity, and the number three is on my mind today because this is the third time I've been blessed to be with this group of saints. And so I'd like to use some words from Patrick that are on my mind today from his breastplate. I arise today through a mighty strength, the invocation of the Trinity, through the belief in the threeness, through the confession of the oneness of the Creator of creation. And so we pray, Lord God, we remember today the great gift of your Spirit among us, not only through the witness of your St. Patrick, but through the witness of so many of your blessed people who call your beautiful creation, Ireland, the land of their birth and that of their ancestors. Filled with your Spirit and inspired by St. Patrick and all the nameless saints who have called Ireland their homeland, may we celebrate today with great joy and give you thanks for your many blessings upon Ireland and her children and her many friends. Amen.
You may be seated. Deacon, I don't know where you think you are, but I looked out while you were speaking and I didn't see any saints.
Saints to be.
I'd like to introduce some of the dignitaries in town, State Senator Joe Vitale, Assemblyman Craig Coughlin, Council President Kyle Anderson, Council Vice President Michelle Sharmello, First Ward Councilwoman Nancy Drum, Fourth Ward Councilman Jim Major, Councilman-at-Large Jimmy Carroll, Councilman-at-Large Greg Ficarra, Councilwoman-at-Large Brenda Velasco, from our Board of Education, Dan Harris, also from the Board, FTO Tamborello. And now we will proceed with a musical selection from the great Paul DeLeo. Thank you. Thank you, Paul. I'd also like to thank our town hall jack of all trades, Don Larson, for all your help in putting this together today. Thanks, Don. And as soon as we're done, you got to fix the clocks. They're an hour off. I want to say happy birthday to John Farwell. Happy birthday. I also want to introduce Glenn Slavin, who'll be doing singing our national anthem outside later. Glenn, thank you. And now it gives me great pleasure to introduce the president of the American Irish Association of Woodbridge, a Menlo Park Terrace native, which means the guy's a great, outstanding individual, Mr. Ken Egan.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I appreciate it. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our 41st parade. I'm not going to speak a lot about the parade. However, I'm going to speak about the club a little bit and about a bit of our theme, which is labor. First of all, just a little bit about myself. I'm in the tail end of my presidency here, and I used to have long hair. Now I have none. But my wife says I'm a much bigger man because I put on about 100 pounds. Okay. In any event, John was talking about our history, and I come from Menlo Park Terrace, and a lot of great people came from Menlo Park Terrace. We have, for instance, the Egans are next to me, and the Egans are behind me, and of course, we're in the middle. There's three Egan families on Kelly Street. My son was looking to buy a house in the neighborhood, and I told him, you know, he says, you know, I saw one in the back that. I says, you know, Patrick, you know how we're Irish and it's about labor? Well, it's sort of like a caste system. The aristocracy lives on the front street, like Kelly Street. And towards the back, you know, if you live back there, you might become something like maybe a mayor or a lawyer. You know, you really want to have a decent living, you know, my son? That's it. That's just a joke, guys. I don't want to get pulled over by the Woodbridge police on the way home. So that's it. With no further ado, this club is run by officers and directors and, of course, all our club members that put so much into our efforts each year. We're not just about the parade, we're also about doing community events, feeding the homeless for one, the veterans, very important to us. So at this time, I'd like my honorable staff and directors to please stand. Don't sit yet. I just thank you from the bottom of my heart for helping me carry through this presidency. For without you, this would never happen. And I appreciate you and I salute you. Thank God for all of you. Thank you. You may be seated. Okay, I'm about to introduce Barbara Thompson, who's our parade chair, who really worked to put this parade together with all the committees. But I'm not going to talk about that because I want her to really honor everyone and direct them. But what I'd like to say is I'm so proud and so happy to be married to my lovely wife, Nancy, who's Irish Woman of the Year, but that's the only one I'm gonna mention, okay? And Nancy's such a sweetheart. She's such a tiger at home, though. You don't get to see that. And one other footnote, because I don't wanna get it passed. This is the first time in history that we have a mother and daughter Irish Lady of the Year. And that would be Jessica Jacko and her mom, Mary Alice. Congratulations. Now, with no further ado, I'd like to call on Barbara Thompson to come down here and say a few short words. Very short.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us for the kickoff of the 41st Annual St. Patrick's Day Parade, the crown jewel of the American Irish Association of Woodbridge. As you know by my title, I'm this year's parade chairperson. I was honored to orchestrate this parade with the hardworking committee to get this parade on the street. Before we begin celebrating, I'd like to take a moment to thank those of whom this event would not have been possible. Thank you, Mayor John McCormick, for he is not only our mayor, but he's also our member of the association. Thanks go to his administration and town council, and to all the town workers who so diligently prepared our community for this parade. Another thank you is extended to Middlesex County Cultural and Heritage Commission, the Woodbridge Township Cultural Committee, and to all individuals and businesses who so willingly supported in our ad journal. My sincere congratulations to our 2014 parade honorees, Grand Marshal Frank Darcy, Irish Woman of the Year Nancy Egan, Irish Man of the Year Larry Malosha, Miss American Irish Jessica Jacko, and Lady-in-Waiting Rebecca Gardner. I salute our parade committee for the nonstop work that they did putting this parade together. I truly enjoyed working with all of you. Can my parade committee please stand if you're here? Thank you for all your hard work. Finally, a word to most important and strong supporter, my husband, Ed Thompson. And thank you, my sons, Peter, Philip, Vinny, and Eddie Jr. for putting up with me through it all. I feel the luck of the Irish is definitely with us today. The weather is beautiful, so let us have a great parade. Thank you. No, you can.
Thanks for all that time to prepare. I'd now like to introduce the 2014 Grand Marshal of the St. Patrick's Day Parade. And having done that, and Jimmy can tell you, everybody else in this room has been the Grand Marshal, when you turn the corner, up, down, going down Route 35, and make the left right past the Rio Diner and see thousands of people all over Main Street, it's an amazing thrill. Frank deserves it. He's been involved in this club for a long, long time. Very active, very hardworking, very dedicated to the cause. Ladies and gentlemen, our 2014 Grand Marshal, Mr. Frank Darcy.
Well, first of all, I didn't have to break the window of my truck to get here. I did last year. Anyhow, ladies and gentlemen, my good friends, great friends from the Woodbridge American Irish Club, greatest club in the state of New Jersey. Esteemed elected officials, and I want to introduce my family, my son Frank, his son Owen, his wife Julie, and of course, I'm not quite the comedian that our president is, but my wife Kathy, who is just, you know, all of this newsletter and you know, all the things that I do. I mean, I can't do it without her. She just, she's just right by my side. Then over here, I have my sister, Patricia Ruan, and her husband, Robert Ruan. Thank you. At the end of the day, it's all, you know, the parade is all about family. But aside, you know, I know it's a great day. It's a party day. It's a day families get together. It's also, and I write this in my newsletters here and there. It's also, you know, it's St. Patrick's Day. It's a day of remembrance. It's a day when we have to reflect of what the Irish are all about, what the heritage is all about in our culture. What was done to us in the 17th and 18th and 19th century and how we survived. We survived because St. Patrick brought the faith to Ireland and brought the Irish people together to endure what another country did to us, the British government. Not the British people, but the British government. And they're still doing it today. There's a peace accord in the north of Ireland, and it, politically it's working, but amongst the people, it still has a lot of bumps in the road, big bumps in the road. And I have to say, the parade was dedicated to my dad, who passed away in December, for his quest for the freedom of Ireland, for justice, for peace. And this is what he always stood for. And that's what I'm all about. I proudly display my Sinn Féin pendant given to me by Gerry Adams. I proudly display the IRA pin that my dad wore. He was involved in the IRA at a very young age before he came to this country. These are the things that's also about St. Patrick's Day and why we survived. We survived because of St. Patrick bringing this whole nation together as one nation. Dad's always ended anything that he had, any articles, any ads that he put in. The fools, they've left us our opinion dead. And whilst Ireland holds these graves, Ireland unfree shall never be at peace. He lived that and he died with that. God bless Dad. God bless the Irish. Thank you all.
I'm sorry, Deacon, we do have one saint in the room. That's our Irish Lady of the Year, because she has been married to Ken Egan for 33 years. I'd now like to introduce Nancy Jean Hendrickon Egan, the Irish Woman of the Year for 2014.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad you're all here. I just want to say thank you to the American Irish, to the parade committee, to my husband, for this great honor of being Irish Woman of the Year. It's a beautiful day outside for a parade, and let's all have fun later on this afternoon. Thank you.
Now, if you're confused by this next selection as the Irishman of the Year, don't worry. So am I. Because I always thought you had to be Irish to be honored by the Irish Club. And in about 7 months, this man will stand here dressed with his wife as Christopher and Mrs. Columbus at the Irish parade. It's not a parade, but a ceremony, the Italian ceremony. And I'm very confused by the fact that Larry Melosha, it ends in a vowel. I don't get it. I don't get it. But maybe at some point we'll all figure out what's going on here. But this is a man who does a great deal of work for the club. He's involved in everything. His wife Claire was the president a couple of years ago. They're together all the time at all the functions. They really do a great job for our club, as does the rest of our honorees. I'd like to now introduce the Irish, parentheses, Italian, Man of the Year, Mr. Larry Melosha.
Like the mayor said, it's a interesting assignment that I was given, being of Italian extraction from County Barry. Town Torino is where my parents are from, and it's a couple of thousand miles from there to Dublin, but in the heart, it's very close, okay? And I have to admit with all humility that it was quite an honor to be selected by the parade committee to be Irish Man of the Year. And like the mayor, I questioned the wisdom of selecting one of lesser Irish descent than I, and again, it was a humility and with honor that I accepted it. But I have a lot of people to thank, especially my wife, a fine mess that she got me into. But it has been an interesting and fun run, and thank you to a lot of people for it, especially my family, both near and extended, the Barcelonas, and how many other branches of the family are there, my dear? But there are quite a few, and a lot of friends that I have to be thankful for their interest, their help, and their forgiveness for doing the job that I'm trying to do. Again, I thank everybody, and I hope the blessings are upon all our honorees for today, and I hope the wind dies down, too. Thank you.
Our Miss American Irish is part of a family with a long tradition of involvement in the American Irish Association of Woodbridge. You know, her grandpa's probably looking down today very, very proud. Our grandma's here, mom and dad, everybody in the Aston / Jacko family. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Jessica Jacko as Miss American Irish 2014.
First, thank the American Irish for this great honor. It means so much to me to be Miss American Irish this year. As was said before, my mom was Miss American Irish in 1984, and it's such an honor to follow in her footsteps, as well as honor my heritage that my grandparents have instilled in me. Thank you.
Our Irish lady in waiting also comes from a family with a history of service to Woodbridge Township. Her dad, Ken Gardner, was the council president back from 1992 to 1995. Boy, do I want to forget those years. And he's also a fireman in town, serves on the Board of Fire Commissioners, and is dedicated to a lot of causes and has gotten involved in the club here. So I'd now like to introduce Rebecca Gardner as the Irish lady in waiting.
I just wanted to say thank you for the great honor of being lady-in-waiting. I am ecstatic about it. I can't wait for the parade today. Something I've been looking forward to my whole life. Can't wait to follow in Jessica's footsteps next year. I just want to thank everyone for coming out and supporting all of us, especially my family, my parents. You guys are great. And my brother, who, like I said, is in her, has the red hair. Not me. So I just want to say thank you, and I hope we have a really great parade today.
You know, Kenny mentioned a bunch of the things the American Irish Association does for Woodbridge Township. One of the things is the Tooling Around the Town program, and that's where homes that are in need of repair, usually senior citizens, usually widows, can't afford the repair, so the different groups get together and go out and fix the house, paint, clean up, landscape. And I have to admit, when they first brought me the idea of the Irish Club fixing somebody's house, I was scared because I know I'm Irish, I can't do anything around the house. I figured the only thing that would happen in that house, there'll be plenty of coolers. But then I realized that Eddie McSherry was gonna be the captain, and Eddie's a very, very dedicated worker for Town Hall. He's an incredibly talented carpenter, electrician, plumber, you name it. So when I heard Eddie McSherry was on the scene, I said, okay, Eddie can do all the work. Everybody else can just sit around and take direction from him. He's one of the parade co-chairs. We haven't mentioned him yet today, but I want to congratulate and thank Eddie McSherry. I'd like to bring up our dignitaries to present proclamations. We have mayoral proclamations, we have legislative proclamations, and Congressman Frank Pallone, who couldn't be here today, has congressional proclamations. And Joe, are you prepared? Joe Vitale is prepared to announce Jimmy Carroll as the Italian American of the Year this October. We gave them one, they got to give us one, you know? Senator Vitale.
morning. Mayor, just for your information, that Italian day you were talking about is Columbus Day. Italian thing. It's great to be here, and it's great to be among so many friends and the American Irish, and be able to speak to your group today and the assembled friends and the honorees. Congratulations on what is really well earned. I'm a member of the Hibernians in South Amboy, and let me tell you the quick story, the background story on that. So I've Tom Dempsey is a old friend from South Amboy. Have been after me to join. I said, oh, I'd love to join. It's a great group. They do great civic work in South Amboy, a great group of people. And so I'm filling out the application, and it starts out with, are you Irish? No. Anyone in your family Irish? No. Is your wife Irish? No. Anyone in her family Irish? No. Are you Catholic? No. I said, Tom, what the hell am I doing here? And he said, do you have $75? I said, yes. He said, you're in. So I'm a proud card-carrying member of the Hibernian South Amboy. And also happy to be here today to honor, recognize all the honorees for their great work. And around this room, a lot of friends and people I see in the community. And that's what the American Irish are all about. Not just in terms of their heritage and honoring that. But you also honor that by being so involved in our town and in almost every walk of life and almost every endeavor. And for that, Township of Woodbridge is so much better. So thank you for that, and thank you for honoring our great friends today. Have a great day, great parade.
Good morning, everybody. I also have the great privilege of being a member of the South Amboy AOH, and it reminded me, Joe, Tom told me he didn't get the check this year. So you're on probation unless you got it and you give it to me now. Let me first thank and congratulate the club on another job well done, both in terms of putting together this parade, which is really a signature event here in the Township of Woodbridge. It's the product of an awful lot of hard work and a great commitment to our Irish heritage. I'd also like to congratulate them on their selections for their honorees tonight. How impressive were Jessica and Rebecca in their remarks. They deserve a big round. They were just as poised and as talented as they can be. Nancy, I think you do qualify as a saint, and I'd like to congratulate the club for its big tent approach in selecting Larry to be the thing, and its courage for picking Frank, which once this videotape will airs, will probably put the organization on a watch list with some federal agency. So congratulations to that. It is a very terrific group, and it's a great honor to participate in this. We have resolutions for each of you. From Joe and from John Wisniewski, who's ill and sends his best. He talked to me just as I was pulling in the parking lot. And from me, of course. And Frank, we also have a resolution for your dad, who will be honored posthumously today for his great commitment to his Irish heritage. And to all of you, thanks for coming out. Thanks for making a difference in Woodbridge. And have a great day, everybody. Let's have some fun. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Craig. The good thing about being mayor is I have editorial review of the tape, so I will extract all those IRA references and all those, and I will extract the part where I forgot to say Columbus Day. So my wife Tammy Magliazzi doesn't see that, so I apologize for that, Joe. I'd like to now call you, all of us would like to present proclamations to the honorees. Let me start with Frank, if you'd come up, please. Congratulations again.
Congratulations, my friend. Well done. Well done.
Oh, and this is from Congressman Plum. Nancy Jean Handerhan Egan. She's got anybody from me? All right. Well, somebody's got one. Are you taking a picture or not? You stand up, you sit down. Still have a tough time saying this. Irish Man of the Year, Larry Melosha.
Thank you.
Miss American Irish Jessica Jacko. Irish lady in waiting, Rebecca Gardner. And now I'd like to call back up Deacon William Lang from St. James Roman Catholic Church for the benediction.
After the morning proceedings, my mom is always on my mind because she's the one that gave me my Irish heritage and also formed me in my faith in a very traditional Irish fashion. After 3 years in heaven, hopefully she's forgiven the woman who kept me from being a priest. Far be it from me to challenge the mayor, but I see many saints and I know where they sit in St. James every week, so they are here. And one of the saints asked me if I could dispense them from their obligation for Mass today, and I said, unfortunately, I never became a priest, otherwise I could have. So maybe you're with my mom now saying, why'd you go off with that, by the way, Italian girl? But I do promise that if you find your way to 5:30 Mass today, a deacon does preach. I happen to be preaching, and it actually seems like it's going to be a short one for me. So, but now let us pray. Heavenly Father, may the raindrops fall lightly upon our brow. May the soft winds freshen our spirits. May the sunshine brighten our hearts, and may the burdens of the day rest lightly upon us. And may you, God, enfold us in your mantle of love. May the strength of God pilot us. May the wisdom of God instruct us, and may the hand of God protect us. May the word of God direct us, and may be always ours for this day and evermore. And may he bless us as we celebrate this day. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Deacon. Please join us after this ceremony. We're going to have the flag raising outside, and then everybody's invited over to J.J. Biddings for a traditional Irish breakfast. Mr. Paul DeLeo. I'm sorry. Let me also thank our Marines for coming out here today. Gentlemen, Mr. Glenn Slavin will now sing both the American and Irish national anthems. Following that, we'd like the honorees to come up and help raise the flag. Glenn Slavin.
Thank you, Mayor. Ladies and gentlemen, so that we may honor America, would you please join me in the singing of our national anthem? Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Woo-hoo. and so that we may honor our ancestral homeland, would you please join me in singing the Irish National Anthem, the Soldier's Song? I'll sing you a song, a soldier's song, with cheering, rousing chorus, as round our blazing fires we throng the starry heavens o'er us, impatient for the coming fight. And as we wait the morning light, here in the silence of the night, we'll chant a soldier's song. Soldiers are we, whose lives are pledged to Ireland. Some have come from a land beyond the wave, sworn to be free no more. Our ancient sire land shall shelter the despot or the slave. Tonight we'll man the barn o' well, in Erin's cause come woe or weal, mid cannon's roar and rifles pleal, we'll chant a soldier's song. Thank you.